Hey guys, I hope you guys are enjoying your high school journalism workshop. My name is Nick. I'm a junior at Ohio University, and this year I'm a part of the sports track of the high school journalism workshop. Also on campus, I'm a tour guide, so I'm going to walk you guys through a little virtual tour of Ohio University and kind of give you the sights and sees of everything we have to offer on campus. We're going to start off today at Schoonover Center. Schoonover would have been the epicenter of the journalism workshop due to it being home of the School of Journalism. But there's also going to be a tour of a more in-depth of everything that this building has to offer, everything you're going to see if you choose to come to Ohio University and study journalism. You're going to get very familiar with this building, so don't have to get too in-depth with that, as we're going to be focusing on all the other parts of campus and let that other video show you more what that building has to offer, because it has a ton. So basically today we're going to start off at the front of College Green at the Class Gateway, and basically tells you what this university was founded on in 1804. It's kind of the front and center of Ohio University, and the College Green is beautiful all times of the year with all the trees during the summer, spring, and fall. When it's not freezing cold out, you'll see hammocks, slack lines, all different sort of stuff that college kids do in their free time, picnics, all that sort of stuff happening all on this college green. And so we're just going to keep on walking on this front line right here to the back portion of it to Cutler Hall, where Cutler Hall was completed in 1819. It was one of the original buildings here on campus. It holds the office of the president, which is what it's known for. And all their university leadership is also held in this building. It's also a very familiar building. If you look at Ohio University's logo, this is the building on the middle portion of it, with the two buildings on the side. That's going to be the buildings you see to the right and to the left. And so basically the president is officed in this building. Throughout the week, it will have his own office hour, so you check those out. You go to his office and you can have a face-to-face conversation with our president, which that's what is kind of different from our school than other schools. You can actually have a conversation with the president, and basically he wants to get to know you and basically help you excel any way possible. And that's a really cool thing that happens at Ohio University. We're going to keep moving forward past College Green to East Green now. So East Green is one of the four greens on campus. There's East Green, North Green, South Green, and West Green. All different directions has a green at Ohio University. East Green is really picturesque, kind of like that College Green area with all the trees, buildings. But now this is an area where you can live your first year on campus. This green has residence halls and a market. All the different green, the other two, West and South Green, have residence halls, dining halls, and a market too. And so this is the only green without a dining hall now. But very close walk to the nearest dining hall, which is going to be the next stop after this one, which goes to now South Beach. This is a really cool place to go and hang out. There's two beach volleyball courts here. Right behind you, there's two blacktop basketball courts if you want some outdoor basketball time, and then outdoor beach volleyball time. Again, during a nice day, this is going to be filled with students playing beach volleyball, listening to music, eating food by the trees, that sort of thing. And it's just really a fun place to be when it's nice outside. Not really fun to play beach volleyball when it's raining or cold and snowy. But now we're going to move to the dining hall. This is Nelson Court. This is the dining hall on South Green. We're going to walk right in it through these pictures and this cool feature that this has. And this is the inside of the dining hall. Kind of take you step by step of what this dining hall has to offer. So you're going to enter right there, and right when you walk in, you're going to get your pizza, Italian options, all the way to the bamboo bowl where all your Chinese food options are. Right in front of you is your salad option, which right behind that is a Smoke and Flames, where you can grill option with burgers, french fries, hot dogs, and hamburgers. And then to the left is kind of what it's known for, with its all-day breakfast. A great option it has, and great food here at the Nelson Court, which is included in all dining hall plans. Come get your swipe in, have as much food as you want, and continue on with your day. As we now move to the South Green living area, this is known as the front four. Four new dining or new living residences on campus. One of the nicest as well. It's only sophomores and above can live in this building, in these buildings, because it's nicer and it's known as a suite style, where a suite style is kind of what this looks like. Once I get down here, so you're going to have your traditional living situation of a roommate, but then you're going to have your own bathroom connected with another room, sharing that bathroom as well. So it's 4-to-1 bathroom, which is an upgrade to what you're going to live in your first year, which is all community style bathrooms. And so we're going to move on now to the bikeway. The bikeway is a 22-mile bike and running path that takes you through the beauty of Southeast Ohio. It's nice and flat, as you can tell. This guy's enjoying his time waving to us. And this is only a portion of it, but you keep on going one way or the other, it doesn't really change. You're still going to be riding along the river, seeing these pretty colors of the trees, and enjoying your time. If you like to, you know, ease your mind with a run or a bike ride, kind of get your mind off things, this bike path is really nice because it can take you right off campus, but still, you know, be on a solid path and kind of know where you're going one direction or the other, and just kind of let your mind kind of slip away and not really think about school that much. So a great option for you if you're looking to get in some exercise or clear your head with a walk or bike ride. Another way you can exercise is the Charles J. Ping Recreation Center. This is one of the largest in the nation for student recreation facilities. And we'll kind of walk in to it here and kind of show you the different stuff it has to offer. So right when you walk in, you see this mammoth of a rock climbing wall. Right when you walk in, a nice intimidation factor for you. This rock wall is kind of like a bucket list item for all Ohio University students to kind of do it at least once before they graduate. A lot of people do it different times. A lot of people like to do it really often. Some people only once a year. Others like me just do it once before they graduate. I still need to do that. I need to get on that. But it is a great, you know, kind of thing to look at and really cool thing kind of get your mind to just do one thing before you graduate. And now I'm moving on. This is one half of the side of the rec center. Three basketball courts here. The other side has three more, so there's six basketball courts total in this facility. Really new and renovated courts. The one behind that wall right there is multi-purpose, so there's also indoor soccer played there, indoor hockey, all different kinds of stuff can be played in that part of the gym area. If you like 5-on-5 basketball, basically you can come any time throughout the day and people are hooping, having a good time, and you just join in a pickup game any day, any hour, normally, and just have a good time. Now you're going to move to the second floor of this facility, where you're going to have treadmills, ellipticals, free weights, that kind of thing. And this is more of your endurance style running. If it's cold, bad day outside, you don't want to use the bike path, you can use the treadmills, or you can go up to the third floor here. There's not a picture of it, but here on the third floor is a indoor track. 10 laps for a mile. Really easy to use, really fun to use, and kind of just a different setting for you. And then if you want to get in a workout with lifting weights and this area is too crowded, you can go back down to the first floor and here's what that has to offer for you. A lot of free weights, a lot of different machines for you, bench press, all that fun stuff. There are also classrooms where you can, you know, go to a CrossFit, yoga, aerobics, all that different kind of teaching style, class setting, workout you can go to, and they're offered for you. This facility is at no added charge to you being a student on campus, so you can come here as many times as you want during the day and get in a workout if you choose to do so. And now we're going to move on to Peden Stadium. Peden Stadium is the home of the Ohio Bobcats football team. Cool thing about Division I athletics at Ohio University, those are free for all students to come and watch. So if you want to watch a football game, free, basketball game, free, anything you can think of as Division I athletics, you can come to with your student ID free of charge, and you can get into them for free. The two main sports at Ohio University that most people go to are football and basketball, and this is the facility that you would go to for your Saturday football games, as well as we are in the Mid-American Conference, which we have the midweek action where Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, you could be going to a football game that night just due to the scheduling of the schedule. Most of the time, the second half of the season, their games are during the week. So it's kind of a good way to clear your mind of school and stuff. If you don't have an exam the next day, you can go to a football game, enjoy watching that, kind of take your mind off classes, that sort of thing. Really fun to go to. Kind of show you guys the pictures of what the crowd atmosphere is like. This is what it used to be like. It's still sort of like that, but as you can tell, the student section has moved over to the left stands. I'll kind of show you a picture of that. Football team running out of the Bobcat there. More students. Atmosphere. This year was the 150th anniversary of college football, and that was actually the only game was being played in Athens, Ohio, and so there was a sellout crowd of students. So this is what that game looked like at Ohio University. This isn't the actual game, but pretty similar to it. It was a blackout game against Miami of Ohio, kind of Ohio's rival team, and it was a really fun game to look at fans-wise. Full house, really cool atmosphere. And then one thing that we are known for is the Marching 110. The most exciting band in the land is their motto. Their halftime shows excite the crowds. A lot of people come here just to see them perform. And it's just a really fun time just to watch them, you know, do their routine and their songs and really have a good time with it. So this is kind of the football field from afar. It's kind of like an overview of campus, more sky view of the field. Really cool, really beautiful campus, as you can tell. And so we're going to keep on trucking here to the Academic Research Center. This is a newly, recently built facility on campus. As you can tell, a lot has been done with renovations on campus to kind of get new buildings in, get the new style feel to it, and this is one of the newer buildings like that. A good area to study. This is on West Green. This is the farthest point of West Green you can get to, basically. I can kind of show you. So this is all of West Green here, and so this building's right here on the end of it. And so this is attached to the Stocker Center for Engineering, so that's where the engineering school is held at. They're all headquartered on West Green, but this facility and building is open to any student. They also have rooms available to, you know, sign out if you have a club, that sort of thing. You also could have classes here during your first year on campus, and it's just a good place to study. If you live on West Green your first year or second year on campus and don't want to walk all the way to the library, this building has a lot to offer for you to study and now I have to make that long trek all the way down to the library. As we're going to move on to Boyd Residence and Dining Hall. So Boyd is a place that you could live your first year on campus. So you can live right above a dining hall during your first year. And I'll kind of show you the traditional first year living on campus. So let me see here. Here we go. So this is your normal size triple if you choose to live in with you and two other roommates your first year on campus. So you're going to have a bunk bed on the side with the desk, and then the double bunk right here with two beds, desk, a lot of cabinet space, and a lot of area to choose and hang out, hang TVs, study, that sort of thing, put all your clothes and stuff. I lived in a triple my first year on campus. It was great. Had just enough space for everything and kind of got the college feel for it as well. And so if you have any other questions on living areas and that sort of thing, feel free to reach out to me throughout the week and I'll be happy to answer those. So now going back, this is West Green. I kind of mentioned it a little earlier during the Academic Research Center spiel. So these buildings on the right and left are residence halls, and the building straight to your back is the Stocker Center. That's where the engineering building is. All the engineering classes are going to be in that building, as well as in the Academic Research Center. It holds a lot of different engineering classes as well, but you could get stuck in there for different classes. And now we're going to go back to... So that's kind of the residence hall side of things. And then what you can live on top of at Boyd is the district on West Green, which is the dining hall that has a lot of different options to it. Different options than Nelson Court. So if you are tired of eating burgers and Chinese food, you can come here and have a different option for you. This is known as the healthy dining hall. So you can come here and, you know, have a lot of fresh food and a lot of, you know, not fried and not as, you know, French fries and burgers type of food. You can get a different option here. A lot of different, you know, variety, as well as a lot of the same. So there's always going to be a salad bar here with different options there. Then at the Carver's Cut, there's always going to be rotisserie chicken, that kind of stuff. And then there's always going to be a different sort of meat here on Sundays. They have steak cut right in front of you, put on your plate, really fresh, really good food. And then right here is Between the Bread, which is a sandwich, you know, bar area type of thing. You put in your order on a computer, you send it off to them, they'll make it, they'll shout out your name, and you come and get your sandwich. Easy concept, really good food. And then behind that, there's no really pictures of it, but there's a Mediterranean style type of food, like pitas, that kind of food, all right beside that. And then behind that is Stir Fry, where you can get rice, noodles, vegetables, and different sort of meat all in that as well. And it's really good. Again, it's, you know, a healthier option for you if you're looking for that. And also for health conscious, there's a gluten-free area where everything is touched by someone that only works in that area. So you're not afraid of getting into any allergies or, you know, gluten-free or vegan, that kind of stuff. So if you're looking for that and really conscious about that, there's an area for you where you can go and basically be not afraid of getting in any of that sort of stuff. As we move on now, we're going to move towards back towards Schoonover, kind of did our walk out, and now we're kind of starting to come our way back towards Schoonover Center. We're going to move to Emeritty Park. This is a park with benches. Again, it's kind of one of those picturesque places where you can just hang out in nature for a while and enjoy yourself, kind of take your mind off classes. But also, if you like to enjoy classes in nature and, study and do all that sort of stuff, the Wi-Fi does cross over to like these areas, and so you can be checking your email or doing homework on your laptop while you're hammocking or watching the water fall and that sort of stuff on a bench. And it's just really picturesque, really nice, really place to be on campus. And we're gonna move towards the Baker Center now. So this is Baker Student Center. This is home to a lot of stuff on campus that you can get involved with. First off, we're gonna look at the pictures here and kind of show you around, because this building has a lot to offer for you as a student. So this is the top part of Baker. You're just at the bottom part you saw a picture of. And so we're gonna go in here. So Baker has 5 different floors. Once this kind of loads, let's see if another one works. Yeah, so this is kind of what you walk into coming off that top floor. Really new and renovated building here on campus. To the left in that area is Front Room Coffee, where you can come get any Starbucks options for you. And then there's a post office, as well as different other offices here on campus are centered in this building. Basically, a lot to offer here in this building. Basically, it is home to the Bobcat Depot, where you can get any laptop, as well as any laptop support you need. As a post office that I just mentioned, Advising Center, Baker Ballroom, Multicultural Center, LGBTQ Center, a theater, and then the coffee shop, as I mentioned. Then on the first floor, there's 2 different dining options for you, which is West 82 and Latitude 39. West 82 is more of a cafeteria style of food, and then Latitude 39 is more of a lounge, nicer setting, sit-down restaurant that you can go to. On traditional meal plans, those are not included, so you basically have to pay the price it has for it. But then if you get the flex meal plan, which is more a swipe, is $6.50 that you can use either at the dining hall or at those 2 options I just mentioned, or the market. And you basically is a swipe of $6.50 to use towards anything in that market or at Latitude 39 or West 82. So that's just a different option for you. Flex is a little more pricey, but you get those different options for you. So I'll kind of, as I mentioned, just everything that there is to offer in this building, I'll kind of just scroll through these pictures to kind of show you. So this is the theater. Different productions are held in this facility. And then the Bobcat Depot right here. When you come and select a major, hopefully it's journalism. But if you choose something else, you come here and you can ask someone what the best computer is for your major, and they have specific cards and stuff to kind of give you a little browsing option for what computer would best fit your needs for your different type of major or, way of college that you plan on going. So it's very helpful. And then you can get plans where if your computer breaks, you can come in and they can basically fix it for you free of charge. And it's just a great place to be at if you need any help. Yeah, so this is the outside of Bobcat Depot. This is the front, or this is the bottom of Baker Center. So kind of saw that walk-in area right there. If you ever do come and tour campus once it's back to reopen, You'll come to the bottom of Baker to this reception area and sign in and then get on a tour. You might have me as your tour guide. You never know. But if you ever do come and get a tour on campus in person once it reopens, you'll be coming to this reception area. Just to kind of throw that out there. Wasn't planning to mention that on this tour, but saw it. I'm going to say it. So, and now we're going to come back to the front room coffee area. So all different Starbucks products are used here, but you can also use your flex points to buy, and it's just a great place to come get your coffee fix. And then this is the West 82 food court, so it's more of a food court option. Has a lot of different styles of food, and you just come get what you want, and then you check out, and you eat, and you move on with your day. So it's just kind of like a dining hall, but it's a little more, it just has the flex point option, and you have to pay out of pocket if you don't have that option. But we're going to keep on moving on and to the Walter International Education Center. And so this is where, if you want to study abroad, you're going to come to this building and kind of ask around your options for that. They'll walk you through all parts of that. If you're ever interested in studying abroad, this is the place to go for that. They'll help you out, walk you through the process. And if you have like financial issues or anything, they'll find scholarships for you to apply to and that sort of thing. They'll be helpful. They're really interested in you getting that education off campus in a place new. So this is kind of what the inside of it looks like. And so if you have like any sort of hint of wanting to study abroad, just come and then ask their questions. And they'll be happy to help you, walk you through all the way. You won't hurt their feelings if you end up not going abroad. So, great place to go and get more information on kind of exploring somewhere new. As we move to everyone's favorite place when they're in college, the library. Alden Library has 7 floors. Each floor is the size of roughly a football field. So it's a huge building on the inside. A lot of room to study. I'll kind of take you through pictures of what the inside looks like. And so you enter it also on the 2nd and 4th floor. So if you come in through this side, you'll kind of see the back of Cutler Hall that I mentioned earlier on in this tour. That's Cutler right there. And so just past Cutler, you enter the library on the 4th floor. And this is what the 4th floor looks like. Again, roughly brand new furniture on the inside. It really makes it easy for group study and that sort of thing. With the library, the higher up you get, the more quiet it gets. So the 6th and 7th floor are dead silent. You can barely hit a nail, hit the floor. It's as quiet as it can get. You will be asked to leave if you are even talking to someone. It's for those people that just really want to concentrate. And then as you get lower, you get more group study areas, more talkative stuff, more collaboration. But then again, there are some areas on those floors, as I said, there are very big floors where it's very quiet, the group studying, and they space it out very well. So that's what the 4th floor looks like. Kind of show you around, kind of stop talking to show you just the different parts of the library. This is the 2nd floor. So the 2nd floor is where you can talk to a library specialist. You can also talk to a library specialist on the 4th floor if you have any of those questions on books and that sort of thing. As you can tell, there aren't any books on the 1st through 5th floor. They're all on the 6th and 7th floor. We call those floors the stacks just because those are where all the books are. As we keep on trucking along here. So a lot of different computers. As I mentioned before, the Bobcat Depot, most people in college do choose to buy their own laptop, but in the library and other buildings on campus, there are computers for you to use free of charge as a student on campus. So it's not a necessity, but it is a highly recommended thing that you do, purchase a laptop. It'll help you out tremendously. So we're going to go back to the second floor. Once I find it, here we go. Yeah, so back to the second floor area, and I'll show you. So this back wall here has different rooms for you to basically sign to use if you have any group projects. Let's see if there's any photos on this side of those rooms. No, you really can't tell. But there are rooms for you to use if you have a group project. You can sign them out for you and you'll have 2 hours to yourself, and a really good way to block yourself out from the rest of the library, as well as getting a really good group project in. Other things in the library, there is a coffee shop. There is the Academic Advancement Center, where it has tutoring options for you. And then the Writing Center, where you can get revisions for any paper you have on campus as a student for free. You just come in, you ask them to look over your paper if you have a general question. For me, I had a big paper, walked in, their office hours, got it done. I got my question answered in 15 minutes. Very free and friendly place to go just to look over any big paper. And it is known that they advance your grade a little bit more than what you would have done if you didn't go there. So that's the library for you. Big space, big area. It does get very crowded during finals week. So, you know, those rooms I did mention, you can rent those out for 2 hours at a time. If you want to get a group together to go and study during finals week, go and have yourself a time getting ready for those finals and grind it out and get those A's, because we love that. As we move on to Copeland Hall, this is the home of the business area. Business school on campus. It is nationally ranked. So again, if we want you to choose journalism, but here's a different option that you could see yourself going in. This is the business area. I also wanted to show you this because, as you can tell, we're kind of back to where we started. So there's Schoonover, and then there's Copeland. And then right behind that is where all your gen eds are going to basically take place, in that building right there. So it's a short walk from Schoonover. All your general education requirements are most likely going to be in that building right there, and a lot larger lecture halls and area for you to go and basically take all the requirements before you get more in depth into journalism and those type of journalism specific classes. As we're going to continue on here back to College Green. So I showed you the front part of college. This is kind of the side. This is the college gate. And so basically as a freshman, you'll have all your meetings at the Convocation Center. And then from the Convocation Center, you're going to walk up behind the Marching 110 through this gateway, kind of entering your 4 years at Ohio University, or however many years you are at Ohio University, in the College Green, where they're going to throw you into an involvement fair. Again, not really sure what this year is going to look like, but hopefully we get back to a full-on involvement fair soon, where all the lines are going to be full of different organizations you can join, Greek life, journalism-specific clubs, as well as Club Ultimate Frisbee, Club Rowing, all these different sort of clubs that you can come to offer. And so it kind of gets your 4 years started with joining a bunch of clubs, kind of enjoying that stuff. And then you're going to graduate back in that convocation center, and then you're going to walk the other way out, kind of ending your 4 years. As you can see, the inscription says, "So enter," on the opposite side, it's going to say, "So depart," taking basically what you learn into the world and enjoying your time. And so this is kind of where our tour is going to end. As you can tell, Schoonover is right back here, kind of ending it back at Schoonover. So kind of wanted to get you a little taste of campus there in about 30 minutes or so. So again, a lot more to offer. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me through the workshop. I'll be happy to answer those. Most other J Crew members would be able to answer some questions. If they don't, they'll come to me and I'll be happy to get that answer for you, but feel free to ask. I'm happy to help. And basically, I hope you guys are really enjoying your high school journalism workshop. Sorry it's not in person, but hopefully we're back there soon. And again, any questions, feel free to ask, and enjoy the rest of your time. Hope this helped, and hope you got to see a lot of campus through this, and enjoy the rest of your time. Thank you, guys.